Alright, Shalom, Shalawam. I want to start off by giving our praises and honor and glory to YAHAWAH, BAHASHAM, YAHAWASHI, BAHASHAM, Rakah Kwadash. I want to give double honors to my elders and the apostles of the house of David, Great Millstone, GMS, that rule very well, Shalom, Shalawam, to the hopeful elect that are scattered to the four corners, the four winds of the planet, of the earth, okay? This is Shemaiah, all right, doing a quick video on this video that you brothers and sisters see here. Man busts up girlfriend face after losing his temper, and she records aftermath. This video, I just wanted to make a few comments on. Hopefully it is edifying, you know, because if this is true, what really happened in this video, it is evident that, again, you women, if it's the first time that it happened, hey man, you should leave. But if this was not the first time that this had happened to her, hey man, you have no one to blame but yourself. But you know, but again, no man should be putting his hands on a woman like this, man. Come on, it's totally ridiculous. You know, busting her eyes up, her face is swollen. Let me play the video, and I'm going to scriptures as well afterwards. And again, I hope it's edifying. Start off in the beginning of the video. You know, it's pretty sad. The sister can't talk. She's a so-called Jamaican from the tribe of Benjamin, or she's a so-called Negro from the tribe of Judah. You so-called Negro, Latino, Native Americans are Israelites. This sister's face has been busted up, and you know, it's the thing of, if you're with a man or a woman and they're violent, hitting, leave. If a woman is putting her hands on you more than twice, once, depending, it's on you. It depends on you. Salakia. But it is very, very wicked when you are with someone and they're abusive. That's off. Okay, and what I mean by abusive, I'm not going to use that word violent. You know, they're violently harming you, hitting you all in the face. Like this sister's face is looking now. Look like she got into a boxing match, man. Okay, shit looks terrible. Now, I don't know what she said to him. I don't know what happened, but I'm gonna play the video. She's going to say a little what happened, but again, you daughters of Zion, you Israelite women, you like thugs, you like niggas. And the first time I seen this video, I was very upset. Because I was upset, man. I'm thinking, man, this could be my daughter, man. Damn, man, this could be my daughter. This could be my little niece. This could be my little cousin. And you know, a lot of fathers would kill over their daughters. A lot of brothers will kill over their sisters. For you to see this, you have to understand, as a father, would you go to jail over your daughter if this would happen? Or any of your cousins? See, the thing is, cousins, uncles, fathers, the thing is, brothers and sisters, all right, you Israelites, man, you have to know a person before you give them away to your daughter. This is why the woman is not supposed to be given away. Give herself away to a man that, you know, she outside, in the mall, walking on a block, on the internet, Now things happen. Your daughter is in the world, would have you, so be it. But you have to interview that man. You have to fully examine that man before you give your daughter away. And a lot of these women, you're not capable of giving yourself away to any man because, again, you're not a virgin. And, if you know, you not being a virgin, man, you went from dick to dick to dick to dick to dick. So you don't have your shit together. Because a lot of you women say you have your shit together, but you do not. I know I'm rambling in the beginning of this video. I don't care. The point is, you women don't have your shit together to be giving yourself away to a man just because he looks good. You know, you're attractive to his looks or, you know, what he's driving. You women in Israel, you're out of order, man. Now, I don't know how long she's been with the brother, but again, you have to fully examine that man, the father, the brothers. Can't let anyone deal with your daughter. So, you know, this is kind of her fault, man. You know, for him to do this to her face, my gosh. Let me continue to play the video. I comment while it's playing. It sounds like the sister is from New York. First of all, she's on the internet. You know, you so-called black women, man, I'm going to tell you something, man. You shouldn't be on the fucking internet, half naked, taking pictures. If you have a man, you should not be all on the internet. A lot of you, even you Israelite women, so-called Israelite women, you're on the internet. Get the fuck off the internet. If you have a man, you should not be on the internet. You should be invisible. The Lord didn't tell you women to be on the internet acting as if you're edifying anyone. You're not edifying anyone. Now, you can tell someone, you can tell a sister, but you're not on the internet for that. A lot of you love attention. This ain't for you. This ministry is for the brotherhood, man. This ministry is not for the sisters. You are only supposed to be a help to the brotherhood. Assist the brotherhood. Not act as if you're a teacher. All right? And don't give me that, there was women prophets in the Bible. No. You know what a mailman is? I don't want to go into that. But you understand what a mailman is. You're only delivering. You don't really understand the message of what you're saying, you women. All right? You're a mockingbird. You're not deep in the scriptures at all. You listen to a man teach you. So you understand it in a way. But you don't fully understand the mysteries because it wasn't given to women. It was given only to men. But you will understand certain, you know, teachings in different books, in the book of Jeremiah, in Ezekiel, and Isaiah, because the Lord may open your eyes to get something for your own faith. You understand? But this is not for you to be on the internet teaching and, you know, all that shalom, and you all in the pictures. Come on, man. That's off. You women, she's on Instagram. It looks like she's on Instagram. I'm not sure, Ahchyam and sisters. But she's on Instagram. You know, being in a... what is that word? It stuck my tongue. an attention whore on the internet looking for attention. She got her ass whooped. Again, I'm not condoning this. I'm not making fun of her, but this was judgment. Brothers and sisters, this was judgment. The Lord said what? I, the Lord, do all these things. I make it good and evil. Peace. If there be evil in the city and the Lord have not done it, the Lord do all things. If there be evil in the city, the Lord have done it. Okay, the Lord create good and evil by sending evil angels. Okay, that's in the book of Psalm 78. The Lord don't play, man. The Lord make it poor and rich. The Most High controls the hearts of kings of men. So what this sister done, man, she neglected the Most High, her first love, which is the Holy Bible, the scriptures, the commandments. She's been given to a wicked ass nigga that done this to her, man. He could have killed her, man. He could have put her to death. But you so-called black women out here, I'm gonna get a good man. Like, I've been talking to this chick, man. I don't want to go deep into my situation. She's a Benjaminite. Pretty. Bad. Bad as hell. But none of that fazed me, brothers and sisters, because again, beauty is vain. My elders and the apostles taught me well, but I've been through that before my elders and the apostles, because I always thought to myself, what good is beauty? What good is beauty if the bitch can't contain herself? If she can't control herself? I mean, she's out of order. She's like a dog. A lot of pretty ones are crazy, crazy ass women. But again, and again, by the way, the word bitch is a female dog. A shameless woman shall be counted as a female dog. That's in the book of Ecclesiasticus. And I'm going to get all them scriptures, because this applies to this sister in this video. But anyway, the sister that I'm talking to, or was talking to, I don't know, she may hit me back up. I don't know. She goes and like her mood change. And, you know, like, you know, women are like the moon. They change, go through different phases, so to speak. So, you know, she may hit me up. But when I was talking to her, she was going through ups and downs. And I was like, you know, you have a mouth like a man. If you weren't talking to me, talking to another man, he may do something to you. If you know, on a third date or something. There's a lot of crazy niggas out here. You know, you women got to stop that, man. You have this disrespectful mouth, man. And, you know, hold on, Salakia. And that's not good. You have to contain that. You have to be discreet. You have to be quiet. Shamefaced. You know what shamefaced is, sisters? You look at the movie Rocky. Rocky's wife was shamefaced. And I love that movie. All Rocky. Rocky 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Rocky's wife, she was a humble woman. She was a quiet woman. She was never loud. She was always, looking down at the ground. Rocky would speak to her. She'd look down and then she'd pick her head back up. That's beautiful, man. That's very attractive. But you nigga women will look a man right in the eyes. You don't even know a man on the street. Then you can look at a man, but look away. That's sexy. That's beautiful. That's attractive. Not a woman, a bitch looking you dead in the eye, you know? That's off. This chick right here, she's on the damn social media and want someone to feel bad for her. You shouldn't be grown. Too grown. You want to act like you're a woman. You know, you're wise. You women always say, I got my shit together, girl. Oh, really? Oh, really? Well, you know, if you had your shit together, you would know what, you know. Again, you have to know people. See, women are not, don't have spiritual discernment. They don't have the spirit. They don't have spiritual discernment. They don't have that. I mean, some women are gifted with certain things, you know, by the Most High, depending. And what I mean by that, being spiritual, not being of this world, but serving YAHAWASHI to the best of their ability, covering their bodies and giving what they can to the brotherhood, helping brothers, certain brother, or being there for their husband. That's good enough, because that's your husband. That's your God. That's your Lord. The Lord may have mercy on you. She may be a wise woman, because some things women know, and the Most High allows the woman to tell you. And you have to be wise enough to discern that. The Most High give you a good woman like that, man. So I'm not putting women down. We respect and honor our women. We love our women of Israel, man. The point is, most of them ain't shit. Okay? They love picking thugs and niggas. And I don't want to use that term, bad boys. I hate that term. Because King David was a bad boy. King David was a bad man. He was killing thousands, man. And women were cheering. Because women love fame. All right? Whooping ass out there on the battlefield, King David. Who is the so-called black man, by the way? Let me continue to play the video. She said he's going to jail. Why would you want a man? See, this is the thing here. I don't know if this is the first time, but this is crazy, man. He's going to jail. He's going to jail. Okay. You know, the so-called black woman, you so-called black woman, this, I believe he put his hands on you multiple times. Now he got to go to jail. Because he just did the most, utmost disrespect. He just totally fucked your whole face up. But he did put his hands on you before, I can tell. You know, you got all these tattoos on your neck, your throat, your butt, your breasts, your everywhere on your damn body. You're marked up like the subway. I'm not judging you too much, but I can. On some aspects. See, come on, man. You know, again, sister. Sisters out there, if you hear the sound of my voice through the Spirit of the Most High, hey man, get a man of the Lord, man. Hey, and hey, that's the only way you're gonna be saved anyway. You ain't gonna be saved by dealing with no nigga. You need a man of God. You need order, sisters. You're still gonna be fucked the way you wanna be fucked. I gotta be raw right now, man, because you know, you women act like we ain't putting a ride down, man. We ain't putting a thing down. Hey. What the elder apostle Tahar say when they was doing a sit down? I love my elders and the apostles, man. I look at that video once in a while. It makes me smile, laugh. Cause you know, the elders and the apostles, they're like our fathers, and they know what's good for us. And if you never had a father, or if you have had a father, or if you have a father or had in your life, you know, they're great father figures, man, fatherly figures. You know, they were talking about the herbs. And speaking about the medicines, yeah, you get that in you. Yeah, she gonna say, yeah, are you done yet? This is getting ridiculous. I'm sorry, I had a cough. Hold on. See, he said, hey, this is getting ridiculous. You know, because you're stroking your woman to death. You know, you're in her guts. But the you know, the point is, man, we're not choir boys, man. You're gonna be happy in the bed. You know, the brother is gonna do what he gotta do. You know, he's gonna make sure he takes care of you. Most importantly, he's gonna care for your spirit. He's gonna want you to be happy, but he's gonna want you to be the best you can be, and not be of this world, because being of this world, you will destroy yourself. Look at hip hop, ATL, what is that? ATL Atlanta hip hop. Reality show, whatever the shit is. Y'all know what I'm talking about. That reality show shit. That destroys our women. They want to dress and be like them. They want a condominium like that and act as if this is their rest, sisters. Sisters, this is not your rest. There's nothing wrong with having nice things. But you have to understand, this ain't your rest, man. A lot of you women out here, you want to be of the world. Being of the world will get you destroyed. Okay, you need a godly man. The Lord's, hey, the Most High said, get a man of understanding. And your father is supposed to give you away to a man of God, a man of understanding, not to a regular dude. Because I wouldn't. He may snap. Salakia. I mean, even a godly man may snap. But when it comes down to it, again, I'm not talking about a Christian. no crazy ass, bugged out ass Christian. And then, you know, he'd justify something if he put, you know, your daughter to death. Well, God said that if she commit adultery, I have to kill her. Look, man. First of all, there's no such thing as a Christian. Okay? That is a derogatory term. We are Israelites, the so-called Negro, Latino, Native Americans. You need to get a man of God, an Israelite. He's the best of the worst men out here. He's going to treat you right. He's going to make sure you're eating right. Hey, you're going to be eating right. You're going to be living the best way you can. You know, a good lifestyle. You know, doing right by you. I'm not saying go to a Pacific camp, but, you know, my elders in the Apostles GMS, that's who I'm with. That's who I've been with for the last 7 years. And this is the camp of brothers you should go to get a man. You know, if you're getting a regular dude out there in these times, in these perilous, wicked ass times, who knows what he's up to? You got a certain job and, you know, you think he's a good dude. You know, he looked handsome or whatever, and, you know, he got a little something, but he may use you, man. Just a wicked nigga. He don't love you at all. He doesn't care for you. Just like this sister. She was probably being dug in. She's going to say a lot of things in a minute. She cared for that man. But he done her wrong, brothers. He done her wrong, man. I think he was using her. But anyway, let me continue to play the video. I just wanted to bring that out. She said, brothers and sisters, he hit me off guard. He hit me off guard. God damn, that dude was wicked as hell. He just snuck out of nowhere. My goodness. I two stories to everything. You know, I don't really know what really happened, but this is what the sister is saying. Let me continue to play the video. She said again, I'm gonna play the video at the end of the video. She said, I took care of him when he was going broke. So again, the sister was doing that for you. I mean, what really happened though? What really happened? Who knows? She probably was committing adultery. But hey, say if she was not, I don't know why the fuck would a man do that. Again, I'm just pointing out the fact that if this was the case, if she didn't do anything, if the brother is fucking crazy and, you know, he snapped, I don't know if she said something, because women can say stuff to make you snap. And women out there, you sisters out there, you so-called black and Puerto Rican women, you can say shit to make a man snap. Cut it out. You shouldn't open your mouth. Hey, when you're angry at a man, it's a certain amount of respect you should still have for a man. You shouldn't snap and just say anything. You shouldn't say anything out your mouth like, fuck you, nigga. That's why other men at my job, they look more worthy to have me than you. I mean, any crazy things that you could think of, you never say nothing crazy, man. Oh, another man would be able to pay for our trip. You broke nigga. Hey, I'm telling you, I heard it before. I heard it like one time in my life with one woman. And I was with her for over 9.5 years, a virgin. And it was coming low points in my life. You know, we come to low points, brothers. You're going to be low. Who's going to be there for you? This chick was running her mouth. I wanted to smack the shit out of her, man. But I said, you know, what you say, bitch? I said, okay. I said, yeah, man. Me having many, many women in my day, many women, when I was in the world, I said, you know what? It's all right. I know what this is about. Soon the Lord is going to cut her off from my flesh, and she ain't right. The Lord going to put her to death, man. She just, her mind is in the clouds. She's totally gone. But, hey, things happen. You have to know how to withdraw from that situation because it's going to get worse. But again, man, this sister said, what? Again, I'm going to play the video. I'm getting to some precepts and wrap up. I was doing everything for him, going broke. So let me get into some precepts, man. Salakia, then I'm gonna keep this short. I think it's in the book of, it's a lot. Hey, that's why we have Google. Have to take advantage of Google, man. All right, there we go. Book of Ecclesiasticus 26 and 23. A wicked woman is given as a portion to a wicked man, but a godly woman is given to him that feareth the Lord. Let me read that again. A wicked woman is given as a portion to a wicked man. So she is wicked, man. She been given to a nigga. Here it is. You done all this for him, and he hit you like that. Now, say if you didn't say anything. Say if you didn't do anything. You were wicked, or that wouldn't have never happened to you. So you still was wicked, even though you was doing. See, two wicked niggas are going to get along, just like two righteous people are going to get along. But two wicked niggas going to get along. But hey, this is deep, man. Let me keep reading. But a godly woman is given to him that feareth. But a godly woman is given to him that feareth the Lord. See that? But a godly woman is given to him that feareth the Lord. So you're going to have a good woman, man. You're going to have a godly woman, brothers, if you fear the Lord. You know, I just wanted to bring that out. Let me bring a couple more scripts out. Let me see. Salakia. I think that's in the book of Jeremiah. That's what I want. So many scriptures going through my head, brothers. I'm just trying to maintain what I want to bring out. Make this quick. There you go. Okay. Book of Jeremiah 29 and 4. I love this scripture here. It's edifying, you know, in many ways. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, unto all that carried away captives, whom I have caused to be carried away from Jerusalem unto Babylon, build ye houses and dwell in them. That's not what we're doing. We had to build others' houses, the heathen, and we have not been dwelling in them, okay? And plant gardens and eat the fruit of them. Verse 6, take ye wives and beget sons and daughters. Take wives for your sons and give your daughters to husbands that they may bear sons and daughters, that ye may be increased there and not diminish. Okay? The whole point in having a wife, the whole point of having a husband is for him to impregnate you. He can bring forth his seed. The rest so the bloodline can continue. You have to understand, getting together is not fucking going to Atlantic City on vacations and you know, buying your woman makeup bags and not planning on family. Family is important. When you set out to have a woman, when you impregnate that woman, a child is like a stock in this captivity. You have to do the best you can, though, because they don't belong to us. But you have to raise your daughter and son up to the best of your ability. You don't want your daughter being a porn star and sucking dick on camera. The point is, brothers, okay, and sisters, you're supposed to give your daughters and sons away. You're not even supposed to let your sons go. Now, me, I can pick any woman I want. I know which woman I need, you know, at this age and the wisdom that I have. I know what kind of female I'm looking for. I'm not careless neither, because, I'm looking at her ass and I'm just in awe, like, oh my goodness, she got a fat, hey, that's great. Titties, beauty, face and everything. Oh, that's great. But how is her spirit, man? She trying to get over on me? What's she going to do to me? Take what I got? Try to take what I got? Who knows? For me to impregnate her and then she runs off? Just saying, brothers. You have to be very, 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 very cautious. You have to be very, don't be paranoid, but be very, very, very patient, man. You know, brothers out here, they think because they're men, or they think they're men, because most of you are not men yet, you know, and you ain't damn sure ain't no king. You have to make king-like decision-making. A lot of you don't have that down pat. You ain't no alpha male. You have to understand the ways of a woman before you get with her deeply. You have to have yourself in order mentally. Me, I'm like a loner. I look at Elder Apostle Tahar and say that at times. No, but I'm a loner as well. I don't really like being in the public, meaning you go to work, you do what you gotta do, help the brothers, be around brothers, you talk. But I like to be alone, man. There's nothing wrong with that. I mean, actually, I get all of my, you know, a lot of things pop in my head when I'm alone. I may be jogging, I may be going to the mall, I got my iPod on, you know, I'm listening to some instrumentals or, you know, classical music. You know, I listen to a lot of classical music. You know, been into music, stuff like that. But understanding music is, you know, listening to music and things like that, get a lot of ideas when I'm by myself. You have to stay alone. Be alone. Learn who you are, brothers, before you jump in a relationship with the woman, because she can destroy you, man. Okay. Salakia. My eyes are burning. That's Satan. Hold on. Eyes are burning like hell. But anyways, you have to stay alone. You have to be alone. You have to know yourself. Be by yourself for a long time, for a while. And, you know, then deal with a woman. Don't be rushing into dealing with a woman. Know the woman. Learn the woman. Learn yourself. Because if you don't know yourself, you might fuck around, she say something or do something to you, you might snap and cut her body up. Brothers, you don't want to be doing that. I'm just saying. You want to know who you are first. You know, learn who you are. I mean, I'm very, 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 very confident in who I am. That's why I can stay away. I don't need to be around my mommy or daddy. I don't need to be around any family members, because again, I am solid. Okay? A lot of brothers not like me. You brothers need to get like that. For the brothers that are in the truth, you should know better. You know, we should know that, you know. But you teaching the gospel, don't be no parrot acting as if you know about something and you don't. You have to learn if you don't know. Because a lot of brothers want to be on a certain level. It's not about that. We're all about teaching the gospel, doing the work for Yahawah, why YAHAWASHI. Pushing his word for Yahawah, why YAHAWASHI, pushing his word for yourself, the elders and the apostles, the brotherhood. That's what it's about, man. It's not about you. It's about the brothers. You want to edify. You want to be a good teacher, all around good teacher in your area, whatever your area is, whatever your gifts are. You want to make sure you You do the best you can do in your field, man. Whatever talent, gift you were given. A lot of dudes are lazy, man. You know, my gift's such. I love going into different topics that the Lord put the spirit on me to go into. So I had to go into this topic because, see, a lot of so-called abuse in our community, and a lot of you women, you don't know how to deal with it. You go back to the man. You deal with the same men over and over again. I don't get this. If you're being all of you women, if you had the sound of my voice, if you've been dealing with nothing but niggas, and you've been so-called abused by these guys, and they hit you so many times, why would you deal with the same kind of men? And I'm not talking about going to no cracker, going to no gook, going to no Arab, Arab, or anything like that. Why not go to a man of the Heavenly Father, of your own nation? But see, a lot of you don't know that. Why? Because you didn't have really a father. A lot of us didn't have fathers growing up that knew this gospel. If you get a man of the Lord, you wouldn't be abused, man. Because any brothers in this truth hitting a woman like that, you going off. Any brothers got to hit a woman like that, leave. All right? But again, let me read it again. Take ye wives and beget sons and daughters. Take wives for your sons and give your daughters to husbands, that they may bear sons and daughters. You know, that ye may be increased there and not diminished. Yeah, you're supposed to have babies. Not to have a good time at fucking Wildwood and Atlantic City and Las Vegas and, you know, stand in a condominium with your woman. No, it's about to be fruitful. It's all about being fruitful. And we really can't do that here, because a lot of these women are horrible mothers, because they have not been taught how to be a mother. They're selfish. You're supposed to put your child before yourself. Like I put a brother before me. Let me do this video for a brother. This may be edifying. Let me do this video. Let me do this. Let me help him out. Let me give money. Let me do this. I put a person before me. But I'm no dummy. I just don't do anything. Meaning, you know, with money. You know, you check a brother. You know, you don't want no men just living a beggar life. You know, begging all the time. But brother need help. You see what's up, help him, man. That's the brotherhood. That's what it's all about. We all run into low points. But every brother should want and have a so-called job. How the fuck we gonna live here? How we gonna be stable here, brothers? Most importantly, how are we going to make it into the kingdom if we're not studying, if we're not examining women, knowing their nature? You know, nature, if you look at the lion, they look at different animals, their prey, you know, before they run up to the zebra and different other animals, the hyenas, you know, they examine them, they observe them in the bushes. And you have to examine the woman, brothers. Can't just get into a woman's panties, think you know a woman. She may snap on you, man, next week, get you killed. You have to know what kind of woman you're dealing with, just because she has a fat ass. You have to be cautious, man. Like a chick wanted me to come to her house, or just go out somewhere, come to her part of town. I said, why would you want me to come so late? Why didn't you know, I'd come during the day. I'm like, matter of fact, man, you know, I'm good, man. You know, matter of fact, let me see you on Sunday. Because I can't see you on Saturday. Let me see you Sunday. Oh, I'm busy. You know, I never been played in my life. You know, because I don't play that dumb shit. I'm very jealous over women, my woman. But, you know, these women out here in 2018, funny, man. Fucking whores for the most part. Most of them are whores, man. You know, don't ever let a woman tell you, brothers, what's going to be or what's going to be that. You set the rules of engagement. You set the rules. Okay? Verse 7. And seek the peace of the city, whether I have caused you to be carried away captives, and pray unto the Lord for it. For in the peace thereof shall ye have peace. Yeah, peace. That's not peace. Her face don't look like peace. Her face look like shit. She got fucked up. You know? Let me see here. Get a couple. Yeah, yeah. Shameless woman. This ain't gonna be long. I'm about to wrap up. Oh shit! It's Satan fucking with my phone. There you go. My hands are too big for these iPhones, man. All right, here we go. Book of Ecclesiasticus 26:25. Shameless woman shall be counted as a dog. I mean a bitch. Count it as a bitch. A bitch. But she that is shamefaced will fear the Lord. Yeah, man. You don't have to understand. You women out there talk about don't call me bitch, but y'all call each other bitches, you women. Then you say don't call me a hoe, but y'all call each other hoes. Just shut the fuck up, man. Either way, you're being called what I'm calling you. And whatever I'm calling you, it is correct. Not a fuck another woman. You got another woman calling you a bitch. No, you are a bitch. You're a hoe, you're a bitch. You're a demon. I had a woman say, I ain't no demon, you're a demon. I say, yeah, right. I say, yeah, right. Yeah, right. Yeah, right. I give you this damn rod of correction, you'll be acting like a bigger demon. You women out here are jokes, man. You women out here are jokes. You're a demon. You don't want a man calling you what a woman is calling you. A lot of you women in this damn time, you irks my soul, man. You're bugged out, man. What else can I bring up? Other stuff. I didn't have anything planned. Ahchyam. I just wanted to bring that out. Let me see. Spirit. Hold on. Jealousy. Oh, here we go. I guess I'll read this. Hey, because he probably was jealous over something. She probably was committing adultery or about to be. I don't know. I don't know the chick. Book of Numbers 5 and Salakia. Okay, 5:12, Salakia. All right, and it reads, speak unto the children of Israel, say unto them, if any man's wife go aside and commit a trespass against him, and a man lie with her cornerly, and it be hid from the eyes of her husband, and be kept close, and she be defiled, and there be no witness against her, neither she be taken with the manner. See, a lot of women be not caught, man, when they be committing adultery, man. But the Most High see your nasty ass. That's why the Lord may have you get cancer, and you crying over your woman, but the bitch fucked and sucked somebody, you know. what else? You know, she, you know, the chick probably got hit by a car. Something happened to her. Hey, because she committed adultery on you, and the Most High got her ass for it, brother. Okay? Things happen to your woman, and you wonder why your woman was a good woman. No, she wasn't. She was sucking and fucking, man. She was doing something. You know, I don't get it. Why would you want to suck and fuck another man when you have a man doing the things you need him to do at home? You women are just double-minded. Hey, the scriptures say in the book of James, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. That's what you women are. If you have a good man, he's plowing you down, right? Meaning putting his rod in you, right? Penetrating you, right? Correctly. He's providing for you to the best of his ability. And you go and sleep with another man. What kind of fucking shit is that, man? That's some nasty shit. Verse 12, speak unto the children of Israel and say unto them, if any man's wife go aside and commit a trespass against him, and a man lie with her carnally, yeah, and, you know, just abomination, man, adultery. I mean, just wickedness, man. And it be hid from the eyes of her husband, and be kept close, and she be defiled, and there be no witness against her, neither she be taken with the manner. And the spirit of jealousy come upon him, and he be jealous of his wife, and she be defiled. Or if the spirit of jealousy come upon him, and he be jealous of his wife, and she be not defiled. You have to understand, a man has a right to feel jealous, like something going on. I don't know, this bitch don't seem right. A man is supposed to, it's the spirit of the man too, man. It's the spirit in men to feel like that. Because a woman out of nowhere acting different, putting on certain lingerie, talking different, walking different, talking to you different. A man is going to think like, this bitch, what is going on with her? He's going to get jealous. That's being insecure. That's called being insecure, ladies. That's called being jealous, ladies. Get the fuck out of here. Talking about a man can't be jealous. Save that bullshit. You're a woman. I'm a man. I'm the king. You are under me. We're not equal. Okay? You're the princess. I'm the king. All you women talking about, why are you jealous? I can't stand a jealous man. I can't stand an insecure man, you dumb bitch. A man is supposed to be jealous and insecure. If you running around doing things differently and acting and talking differently. Let me get ready to wrap this up, man. It's the perfect scripture to hit, too. Salakia. All right, Salakia. And the spirit of jealousy come upon him, and if he be jealous, and if he be jealous of his wife, and she be not defiled, then, verse 15, then shall the man bring his wife upon a priest, and he shall bring her offspring of her, the tenth part of a, what is that, ephah, and barley meal. He shall pour no oil upon it, nor put frankincense thereon, for it is an offering of jealousy and an offering of memorial, bringing iniquity to remembrance. Yeah, because that's the spirit, man. You nasty nigga women out here committing adultery. That's why you have all these fucking paternity tests out here. You are not the father. Yeah, man, because the man didn't know you were sucking in fucking Tyrone. But he found out by that test. But he wasn't finding out like months ago. Sliding on another dick. Riding another dick he never knew about. What a nasty asshole, man. These women are nasty. Most of them are nasty. And when you get on a woman, you put women in order, you hate women. No, actually, we love women. Open rebuke is better than secret love. You're supposed to get on the women of Israel. They belong to us. You don't belong to nobody but us. But since the so-called white man Esau, Edomites, are in rulership, you are given to him. Because it's all about who has the power and fame. And he does right now. But, hey, the beginning of the world is, hey, let me get it real quick. The end, Salat. Esau, I'm about to say, in the world of Jacob. Come on, hurry up. Shit is slow. Book of 2nd Esdras 6 and 9. For Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. Esau is the so-called white man. Amalek, Esau, Edom, the so-called white man, fake Jews. Jacob, are you so-called Negro, Latino, and Native Americans? And guess what? You women, the power is going to be transferred back to us. In the kingdom, we're going to have a forever kingdom, okay? So right now, you know, you're with the so-called white man and what he's all about in his bullshit. It's a lot. All right. Verse 17. And a priest shall take holy water in the earthen vessels, and the dust that is in the floor of the tabernacle of the priest shall take it and put it into the water. The priest shall set the woman before the Lord and uncover the woman's head. Yeah, because you women supposed to wear a head covering. You out here with your weave and shit. Y'all wouldn't be looking a fucking mess for the most part, man. We be looking all fucked up. Just cover your hair when you out. That looks beautiful, man. That looks beautiful. I know the glory of a, I know women, ladies, the glory of a woman is her hair. But damn, sometimes you have to cover your hair up. You have to understand. Try to cover your head, man. Because you need to. Especially you Israelite women talking about you Israel. Cover your head. If you're not covering your head, come on, man. You have ass, okay? It reads, and uncover the woman's head, and put the offering of memorial in the hands, which is the jealousy offering. And the priest shall have in his hand the bitter water that causeth the water, the curse. I'm sorry, Salaki. Verse 19. And the priest shall charge her by an oath, and say unto the woman, if no man have lain with thee, And if thou hast not gone aside of to uncleanness with another instead of thy husband. Again, uncleanness. Key word, brothers and sisters. That's uncleanness when you lie with another man besides your husband. So a lot of you women out here talking about, I'm a good woman, I'm a good catch. No, you're a whore. You don't really belong to me. If you're not a virgin, you don't belong to me. You belong to that first man that that was penetrating your womb, ladies. I just wanted to let you know that. So all you talking about, I'm a good woman and I'm this and that. Number one, stop trying to act like you're so great when you're not a virgin. You're a whore. And if you're not a whore, you need to repent ye and be converted. That's in the book of Acts. Read your Bibles. That's why you women, most of you damn nigga women going to die because you don't read your scriptures. That's why a lot of you be being found dead, car accidents, shot in the head, straight bullets, whatever the case may be. A man put you to death, he beat your ass and he put you to death. It's because a lot of you, them that turn the air away from the law, even their prayer shall be an abomination. And even you sin without the law shall perish without the law. So a lot of you women out here are unclean, dealing with different multiple men that's not even your husband. You women are nasty, man. Hey, that's why the Lord said this is a wicked and adulterous generation that seek after a sign. Hold on, Salak. Salakia. That's why the Lord said that this is a wicked and an adulterous generation that seek after a sign. This is a wicked and adulterous generation. A wicked adultery all around, man. All around. So that's uncleanness. You women are unclean. How do you become clean? A new creature again. Turning back to the Most High. Turn back to the Lord. Turn from this. Get from this world. Repent and be converted. You're an Israelite. Confess your sins when you were in the world. Stop eating pork, shrimp, crab, all that abomination. Become a new creature. All right? Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. That's in the book of Romans, man. You have to be, you know, you have to do that. Verse 20. But if thou hast gone aside to another instead of thy husband, if thou be defiled, and some man have lain with thee beside thine husband, then the priest shall charge the woman with an oath of cursing. And yeah, it's going to be cursed. And a priest shall say unto the woman, the Lord make thee a curse and an oath among thy people. Yeah, a damn proverb and a byword. You fucking whore, slut, nasty, you know, a lot of proverbs and bywords. You're going to be a lot of damn words because you're a hoe, man. Out here sucking and fucking another man and you got a man plowing you down right. And you out here acting a fool, being a whore, being double-minded. Talking about I love a man. Hey, ladies, how the hell can you love me and love another man? I'm about to wrap up after this. Ladies, how can you love me and love the so-called love the next man that you lay down with? So you love him too? You love me and you loved him? Or you love me and you loved... Come on, cut it out. You can't be loving me and love him after you loved him and loved him. You women are such double-minded creatures, man. You know what it is? You just love the dick and the money, whatever that he's providing for your lifestyle. You women are cold-hearted vampires, man. So how the fuck you gonna tell me you love me? That's why, hey, man, you can't say, do you love me and you love him? And then you love him and you love him. All that dick and sperm in your mouth talking about you love him and him and him and him. Impossible. Mission fucking impossible. All right. And the Lord will make thee a curse and an oath among thy people. And when the Lord doeth make thy right thigh to rot, thy belly to swell, and the water that causeth the curse shall go into the bowels and to make thy belly to swell and thy thigh to rot. And the woman shall say, Amun, Amun. Amen. There you go. But that's it on that. I'm going to wrap up. The thing is why I got this. The reason why I got this scripture is because you women out here, that woman in the video that got her face busted, she probably was committing adultery. You know, so brothers, sisters, mainly you ahchyam, man, because you women that listen to me, you know, I don't hate you women. We love you women, even you Israelite women that's trying. We love y'all, man. We're not telling you to get a man of the Lord just because we want to heat women unto us. We don't really have time for women. But it would be nice to have a companion. It would be nice to have a wife, a woman in this captivity, to have this so-called somewhat, you know, same thoughts as us, because, you know, you hate the so-called white man, you hate the heathen nations, and you're supposed to, you know who your enemy is, and you understand what this being in this world is all about. It would be nice to have someone like that lying in bed with that night, man, you know. And but a lot of our women ain't right, you know. They're all about watching reality television, going out wearing tight dresses, wanting to show their nipples. A lot of men allow their women to go out like that, and they really don't argue with their women. They just say, I hope no man ain't looking at my woman when we go. You know, they think like that. But, well, brother, you're not being an alpha male. Why would you allow your woman to go out like that? You know, so, you know, our people are bugged out, man. But it would be nice to have a woman to share the same morals and values, because the Most High, can two walk together and set they be agreed. The Lord said, be on one accord, call on the name of YAHAWAH, BAHASHAM, YAHAWASHI, not the name of Christ, not the name of God, not the name of Most High in Christ, not Yeshua, YAHAWAH, Yahweh, none of that bullshit, Jesus, none of that bullshit, no, YAHAWAH, BAHASHAM, YAHAWASHI, you call on that name, that's the name of the Most High and His Son. And these government alphabet agents out here, they're responsible for the Bloods and the Crips. They're responsible creeping in, trying to get into the ministries and stir up bullshit. They got agents amongst us, man, and gang stalking and shit. Calling brothers' phones, trying to kill brothers in the LA camp. Calling my phone. They've been calling me, man. I don't give a fuck, man. You know, I'm a soldier, man. All right? No servant is greater than his master, brothers. No servant is greater than his master. I lost my wife of 9.5 years, who I truly loved, who I cried with, we went through a lot with, who I went through a lot with. We had a lot of high points, but them low points, she couldn't handle it. But again, amen. It's sister, man. Anyway.